The salmon, now heavy with eggs and milt, sense their time is near as they begin to occupy the spawning beds where their own lives began. Located in the quiet places of river headwaters, we now enter a sanctuary for spawning Atlantic salmon, which few have been privileged to visit. Atlantic salmon have specific and uncompromising demands as they assess and select acceptable spawning habitat. First and foremost is a tributary setting, which will ensure the preferred solitude so cherished by the species. The salmon will quickly abandon the spawning grounds should they encounter what they perceive as a shoreline threat. Other spawning criteria include the river substrate, that is, the composition of the river floor. It is the female salmon which will excavate the actual depression into which her eggs will be deposited. She will select a combination of coarse gravel and river-washed stone rubble between 1/2 to 4 inches in diameter. A distinct combination of stone material is key in permitting the percolation of dissolved oxygen through the nest. With an intuitive understanding of river dynamics and the influence ever-changing water levels will have on the spawning beds, Atlantic salmon appear to reject nesting sites too close to the shore, lest the low water of winter causes the spawn to freeze. Conversely, excessively high water could reduce the velocity of flow along the river floor, thereby impeding the river's ability to cleanse the nest of metabolic waste at the same time it delivers the ever-necessary concentration of dissolved oxygen. While the size, form, strength, and coloration of the spawning Atlantic salmon is truly impressive, it is the imagery of their eyes that will be remembered and is most haunting. Reflecting a complex mix of intelligence, independence, courage, and determination, they have the unmistakable look found only in those creatures who prefer to inhabit the deep wilderness areas of this planet, to be forever shrouded in mystery and intrigue. As a late October sky casts long shadows on the river, the salmon display a distinct change in behavior. No longer reclusive and shy, male salmon are now both protective and defensive. They patrol the outer limits of the spawning beds in search of other fish with an unquenchable appetite for salmon eggs. The weather of late October brings cooling water temperatures to the river. A water temperature of 53 degrees Fahrenheit or lower is necessary to ensure the development of eggs and milt. While the optimum water temperature for laying and fertilizing eggs is between 40 and 42 degrees Fahrenheit, Atlantic salmon have been observed in spawning areas either in the act of spawning or with the mating ritual completed in water as cold as 38 degrees Fahrenheit. Several salmon, presumed to be aggressive males, surface to investigate what they perceive to be a shoreline threat to their spawning grounds. A solitary pair, each perhaps 35 pounds, hold steady in the flow of the river, pectoral fins fanning to maintain their chosen position. A female salmon is capable of carrying 800 to 1,000 eggs for each pound of her body weight. Although a 30-pound hen salmon produces 24,000 eggs, just one pair is expected to survive the many hazards of river and ocean migration and return to their home river as spawning adults. Once an ideal spawning site has been selected, the female salmon will excavate the nest by turning on her side, vigorously flexing or fanning her broad and powerful tail to create a depression in the substrate of the river floor. Months of fasting, combined with miles of upriver migration, begin to take their toll. Her strength and endurance now waning, she continues, determined to sculpt a nest 6 to 8 inches deep into which she will deposit her eggs. Her mate is near her side, ever vigilant. The spawning beds have their own story to tell. Fertilized eggs, now concealed in the nest sites from previously excavated areas, are covered and protected by newly placed overturned river-washed stones, their glowing presence telltale evidence of the treasure they hold. Ultimately, the salmon's travels lead us deep into a tributary setting where the sharing of a secret begins to unfold. Based on the Salmon Conservancy's interpretation of the species' behavior during the pre-spawning phase, it appears that both the male and female salmon participate in the selection of the red or nest site, the male's role being defender and protector of the nest. Under a leaden gray October sky, a pair of Atlantic salmon commence a brief period of courtship while holding steady in the flow of the river. The female makes her first assessment of the spawning bed. A test fanning of the gravel suggests she is satisfied. An intruding male salmon approaches the spawning site. He is quickly turned aside, and the original pair remain over their chosen location. Each satisfied that all is as it should be, the female begins to excavate the gravel of the river floor for the creation of the red. The digging continues. Periodically, she will evaluate her progress by settling over the red to probe and measure its depth with her pelvic fins. Her mate leaves his downriver location to join her over the nest, and, as if with a touching gesture, he moves to her side to assure her of his presence and his waiting. The final stages of sculpting the red will summon all of her remaining strength. Determined, she will perform many separate digs before she is satisfied with her efforts. Her task completed, she beckons her mate to join her. Sensing their moment is near, he moves close to her side. Together, they will give of themselves the very essence of life. For as she sends her eggs into the red, he envelops them in clouds of milt. In an instant, we are witness to the creation of Atlantic salmon as the now fertilized eggs settle into the gravel safety of the red. This is the moment in time when ocean, river, and salmon become one. Their quest realized, the female moves upriver to cover her eggs under a blanket of gravel. As quietly and mysteriously as they return to their river in the spring, their numbers are now being silently lifted from the pools to be swept downriver. From here, they will return to the sea childless, leaving their children to be born orphans. The salmon, with a promise to return, are leaving their progeny in trust to the river. Perhaps it is time for us to depart as well, to leave the river and her unborn Atlantic salmon to the peace and quiet of each other. We turn away as a soft snow begins to dimple the now quiet river.